Hey guys, it's Claire from CDB Eventing again, back with Sandy, Ballet DHI. Today we're going to be doing another episode of CDB Eventing Tutorials. It's another Polework one. It's a supposedly Polework Monday, but we had a poorly horse on Sunday night, so we were all absolutely exhausted on Monday, so it's been put back to today instead. We're doing trot poles to canter poles. I think the best way to explain how we're going to do it is to show you, because the cameraman is being dodgy today. So as usual, Sandy's being warmed up. He's had a walk, a trot, a really good walk with the pole today. A trot and canter. And we're going to start introducing poles again at the beginning of the session. Start with all of the poles on the floor. Over the trot poles just to get them loosened up even further. Important when you're doing poles on the curve, keep them on the, try and keep them as central to the pole as you can. As you saw the time before, you struggled with this one longer than you were outside of the curve. Now we're going to do it on the other rein. Sandy's looking on camera. We're going to do it on the other rein to warm up even further. Make sure you do it on both reins so he's warmed up very nice on both ways. Good boy. And when you're ready, have a canter, pull him to the inside of the trot pole, and go to the cat pole. Move forward. Remember to try and keep it forward and keep them in the middle of the pole. You will have to move with it, otherwise they will find it incredibly difficult. Again, make sure you do this both ways before breaking them. You can actually see already that his stretch has improved after only going over them a few times. Now you can start to incorporate the trot and the canter poles. Go over the trot poles, add in the circle. Circle until you're cantering nicely. And then go for the canter poles. Walk break. You don't want to tire up too much, you don't want to trip in, like I said many
get some impulsion into the trot. Good boy. More head in for the fully raised trot hold.
Sandy's now had a really good warm down. It's very important to walk them. Sorry, there's a pigeon, I got distracted. It's very important to walk them for as long as you can, really, after a session, to walk them off. At least 10 minutes, ideally, even if you are just lunging. That is very hard work for them. Don't feel deceived by the fact he's not really sweating. He is fully clipped, and it's probably about 2 degrees right now. A couple of notes about this exercise. Firstly, you can do it in any lunging aid you want. Although, personally, I prefer not to, so that they can use all of their body to move. Like, when he got it himself a little bit wrong to the first pole, he then had the freedom to move correctly and sort himself out. If he had a lunging aid that's tight, he probably wouldn't have been able to do that, and it would have got a bit of a disaster. So if you do have lunging aids, just make sure they're loose enough that the horse can sort himself out. This exercise under saddle. You can then make the transitions a bit quicker and cut out the circle in the middle when you've got a bit more control on the saddle, because obviously you have control to a point on the lunge, but not immediate control. Remember to start with all the poles on the ground. To judge your horse's fitness level before and strength level before raising the poles or doing extended periods of this, and remember to give them lots of walk breaks and lots of praise. Thank you for watching, we shall see you in the next video.